So we looked at the largest circuit last week. We are heading for the bin of 20 volts by 10 volts of the here, when it's 20 volts of the input. So here's the ideal design, and we're designing that something that connects 50 and 500 volts. Source to 500 ohms as well. So it's matched to 500 ohms. About the ideal values of components, we've chosen preferred values of 150 instead of 167, of 690 instead of 667. So all we're going to do with Multisim is just see how far away from this 20 volts gives us 10 volts. We actually are going to look at it across the range of the wind. Quite far from it. We're looking for the exact half how close to it. Well, how close to that half. So we've got a couple of beats in there. We've got a bit of disconnect with the source. I've still got the load connected here. And I'm going to use this meter here to measure the input units. You know what we want to be? We want it to be 500 ohms, and that's measured with the load connector point that we talked about the half. So if I connect one end of this meter up to the top end, one end, that meter on ohms, switch on. So instead of 500 ohms, we've got 492 ohms. That's down to the preferred values. So we can have a slight mismatch there. So let's measure it to see what the input impedance is after we've changed the preferred values. If we put the 167.7 ohms, it was, we would expect to measure 500 ohms. So here, this meter down here, this one, for the measure ohms, just looking at the output impedance, the source impedance to measure. I wonder how much difference that's going to make to that half ratio that we were before. But I'll just pause again for a minute. Right, what we're going to do now in the meters is use this meter here to measure the output voltage across the load. This meter. Isn't the voltage across the battery, it's the voltage after the source. It's not a simulator So we're looking for 20 volts here, we've got 40 volts there, because this resistor and the rest of the network forms a 500 ohm theory volts divider. If I turn that on now, I'd expect to get 20 volts at the input. I've got 19.6. That'll be down to the mismatch. This isn't exactly 500 ohms for this bit. And the output is slightly more than half of that. Again, down to the preferred value. be expected to take deposits here. Sorry, we'd be expected half that 19, so it's a 9.1. What's half a 19.64? Yeah, so if you do 9.32 over 10.4 times 100. Sorry? 9.82, I guess. Yeah. So, are we within 5% of what we expected? Yeah, 5% of the goals is. Yeah, so you're within the component values of our tolerance, of our tolerance. So when you actually use the various components, it affects that as well. Or you might even bring it back to what you're looking for the purpose, heading on which side of the tolerance. So although we use the resistor value here, it's some 16, 17 ohms away from what would be ideal. At this one's about 30 ohms away from what would be ideal. Not causing such a too big problem. Also, what we could check is do we get a similar result in range, i.e., so we would now expect 10 knots here, 5 knots here. So when you do your practical, you'll make a little table, maybe checking in 1 volt steps. On your input here, the table of your output, seeing what the ratio is between them, is it consistent across the range? Yeah, more or less a straight line. The other thing you'll do is if you use an AC source instead of a battery, you can actually change the frequency, different frequencies, 3 or 4 different frequencies. And make sure that your attenuator is not affected by frequency. Because as you're going to find out today, an attenuator that's affected by frequency is called a fiddle one. And that's not the problem for this type of attenuator on the attenuator. So you're going to be looking to do that kind of thing. We can obviously use it to use your practical and then also build that circuit with the preferred value resistors. Similar tests to determine how close the practical circuit is to what you decide on the simulator. I don't have